G'day, my smart mates. My name's Dylan Dance. I'm a physicist from the land down under.
Grab a coffee, grab a chair,
grab a Vegemite sandwich, grab whatever you want to grab. Let's talk some natural philosophy. I came across this anime because it kind of went viral when a question from the anime was on a physics exam. Fun little fact about the explosive physics of pooping penguins. They can actually shoot their poop over 4 feet. Why? I don't know. But yeah, next time you're at an aquarium or you're just around penguins, keep your distance. I think they did this research specifically for that reason, believe it or not. They wanted to know, you know, how to make penguin enclosures and how close people can get because, yeah. So naturally, they brought in the big guns, the physicists, to explain the explosive physics of pooping penguins. You won't find this sort of wisdom and hot tips or explosive content on Dr. Mike's channel, so make sure you subscribe. I like what they've done here with the broken bones because he's used so much force that they've just shattered. So we can talk about this and the physics of breaking bones because they're not as easy to break as you might think. Ounce for ounce, bone is actually stronger than steel. And 1 cubic inch of bone can withstand the weight of 5 standard pickup trucks, give or take a few pounds. If you're looking for the specifics to snap a piece of your skeleton, it takes about 4,000 newtons to break the average human femur. Don't run out and start applying pressure to femurs and then come complain to me when things start cracking. A lot depends on the bone itself, the position of the bone in the body, and the angle of attack. If you've ever tried the experiment yourself, you probably know that you can't walk through walls. But did you know there's actually a non-zero probability that you can? Now, it's so incredibly small that it is probably never going to happen, but it is non-zero. But particles actually can, thanks to something called quantum tunneling. Maybe one day we'll actually be able to quantum tunnel humans. Now you might think, Dylan, you're crazy. That's just not going to happen. Well, guess what? There's already devices you're using right now that embrace this. We've already created semiconductors where electrons quantum tunnel through non-conducting material. There's actually some types of magnetic hard drives out there already that rely on quantum tunneling to read out data. And then there's the Nobel Prize winning scanning electron microscope, which relies on electrons to tunnel through a tiny finger-like probe and a conducting surface. There are all sorts of experiments going on around the world right now where physicists are trying to tunnel macroscopic objects. Quantum tunneling in mechanical systems are the kind of holy grail that people are looking for right now. And there are all sorts of experiments around the world going on right now. So if that sounds cool to you, you should get into physics. So why can't you use quantum tunneling to walk through walls yet? Well, quantum calculations show that you could wait the age of the universe and still not see someone walk through a wall, but there is still a non-zero probability of doing so. That's pretty much just like trying to do physics. Maybe we should talk about lasers. If you didn't know, laser is actually an acronym for light amplification by stimulated emission of radiation. So a laser actually works thanks to quantum physics. If you pump extra energy into a material, it often releases that extra energy as photons. Those photons then get absorbed by nearby atoms, which then release more photons, and this creates a cascade. And that results in a beam of coherent light. There's actually a form of lasers called tweezers, which uses two beams of light to squeeze and manipulate objects as small as a single atom. I wouldn't expect laser chopsticks anytime soon though, unless your sushi roll is 100 nanometers or smaller. So the problem I have with this scene are that people are so easily able to dodge this laser, which is traveling at the speed of light, which is 300,000 kilometers per second. You see this in all animes and TV shows, but I really don't like it because it makes no sense. So let's talk about this girl negating gravity and throwing this ball indefinitely. Now, if you know at least a little bit of physics, you might think, hang on. My boy Einstein told me that gravity isn't actually a force, it's just the curvature of space-time. And so, you know, turning this ball's gravity off doesn't really make a lot of sense in that context. But what you have to realize is that a lot of people in the physics community believe, we don't have any proof of this yet, but we think that space-time is doomed. So Einstein's general theory of relativity and of gravity, we think it's going to turn out to be a classical approximation of what gravity and space-time are. So what quantum field theory suggests, which is our current best theory of nature, incredible theory, it's what the standard model of particle physics is, a quantum field theory. In principle, GR should arise from a quantum theory as well. This means that there is a smallest possible excitation of the gravitational field. When I say excitation, I mean a particle. Because in quantum field theories, you have fields everywhere, and when you excite that field, what I'm really meaning is you're creating a particle, essentially. So this gravitational field, when you excite it, when you perturb it, you will be creating a graviton. So to rehash, the theory of space-time curvature, GR, should turn out to be the classical limit of the quantum field theory which describes the motion of gravitons. So relating this back to the anime, it may very well turn out that you can do something similar to this, where you can turn off something's gravity by manipulating the gravitons. Pretty wild. Or even the Higgs field. But we've talked about the Higgs field and the God particle before, so we won't go down that rabbit hole again. Have you ever asked yourself, why does it take humans and elephants the same amount of time to poop? Let's talk about the physics of poop. We only discuss the highest quality content on this channel. I remember reading this piece of research a while back, and a team of physicists basically worked with a zoo to look at different animals, different sizes of animals, to basically create a mathematical model of the duration of pooping. And they learned something pretty interesting. The bigger the animal, the quicker the pooping. Which is kind of strange, isn't it? Elephants pooped quite a lot quicker than humans or other in-between sized animals. They actually made some interesting medical discoveries with this research as well, like what determines the shape of poop, and it's the rectum and large intestine, if you were wondering. So this research actually had some practical benefits. It actually helped them design an astronaut suit, basically a big diaper for astronauts that want to stay in a spacesuit for 7 days. And it essentially helped them, you know, pull the feces away from skin. Yeah, I think we'll stop talking about that. We have these animals in Australia called wombats. They're basically like miniature little bears. They're these tiny, well, they're not tiny, they're like this, and they're really fat and small. And you always see them when you're driving out at night in the bush in Australia. They're everywhere, and they're so much fun, and they're really friendly. You try and don't chase them. You shouldn't chase them. But something really fun about them is they burrow into the ground, right? And they sleep in burrows underground, not too deep, and they sleep head first. And because of this, they actually poop cubes. Their poop are cubes. I think that's awesome, because think about it. Why would they be pooping cubes? It's because they can poop in their burrow and it doesn't roll back into them. Genius.
あなたみたいな最高のヒーローに僕も
Yep. It's a bit like physicists. It's a bit of a facade, me talking about all this stuff. Because at the end of the day, you know, what it is a lot of coding and math. So if you're going into physics, be prepared for a whole lot of math. All of it is math. And then when you get into doing actual physics, it's a whole lot of programming and coding, which you're just not prepared for either. So, but you know, it's fun.
So you might have noticed today that I'm actually standing up. What I've realized is that if I'm going to do this job, if I'm going to watch these shows, I need to have the agility to quickly react when I see a bit of incorrect physics. You know, that's what this job requires.
You can expect a lot more random content like this. So please subscribe if you enjoyed that. Apply some time derivative of momentum onto that subscribe button, on that like button. Help me push this video out to other people, and let's change people's perceptions of things like physics and math and show them, you know, it can be cool. I'll see you guys next time. Catch you later.